be great. Thank you for letting us know. We're gonna go ahead and get started. You are here today because we are celebrating El Día de los Muertos, Day of the Dead. And I know we're gonna allow for some time for some people to come in, right? Some folks to come in, and they're gonna be coming in throughout our assembly. But I wanna welcome you. Les quiero dar la bienvenida. Están aquí presentes para nuestra asamblea del Día de los Muertos. El Día de los Muertos tradicionalmente se celebra el primero al segundo de noviembre, pero eso cae este fin de semana, ¿verdad? Y nos vamos a estar juntos. Day of the Dead traditionally falls on November 1st to November 2nd, but we are not going to be together as a school over the weekend, so we decided to do that today. So I want to welcome you, and because it's a regular school assembly, if you remember, we always begin with the flag salute. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen real quick just for a second. Just so you can see our program for today. And we have some Latinos Unidos students that are joining us this morning, and they are ready to, to share a couple of things with us. And we're going to start with our flag salute. Boys and girls. And we're going to go ahead and start with one of our sixth graders. Her name is Allison. Allison, are you here? Miss Chrissy, if you can help me. Yes.
Are you recording?
Yes, I am. There are some parents that requested that we record our assembly because they are not present right now. May I ask for Allison? Allison, are you here right now?
I'm not seeing Allison.
Okay, sorry. So Allison was gonna lead us in our flag salute, but we're gonna go ahead and ask Mr. Hall, our spirit guide, to lead us into this flag salute this morning. Mr. Hall? Mr. Hall, are you here?
I am here.
Okay.
Okay, scholars, let's do the flag salute. Can everyone stand to your feet?
And you have a flag on the Chromebook, so you can use that as your reference point.
And thank you. And then please put your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you so much, Mr. Hall. And I just want to remind all of our scholars, if you can do us a favor and please make sure your mic is muted as we move on with our program. Okay, so I'm hoping Allison is here by now, but just want to make sure. Okay, so we're celebrating El Día de los Muertos, right? And I'm sure the big question that we have is, what is the Day of the Dead? ¿Qué es el Día de los Muertos? We have a couple of scholars that are part of our school-wide leadership team called Latinos Unidos, and they are here with us today, and they're gonna tell us a little bit about what Día de los Muertos, Day of the Dead, is, right? And let's hope we have our scholars ready to go. We're gonna go ahead and start with two scholars, Sarai and Brenda. And Sarai, if you are with us, If we can, perfect, Minita. If you can unmute your mic, you're good. You're ready to go. Tell us, Mija, what is Day of the Dead?
Day of the Dead is a celebration of life, the life of our loved ones that are no longer with us. It's an opportunity to remember them, what they continue to mean to us, and what we can learn from their lives.
Thank you, amiguita. Brenda, would you mind helping us out too?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Mija.
El Día de los Muertos es una celebración de vida.
Gracias to both of you. We are a bilingual school, so we want to make sure that we honor both of our languages. Thank you to both of our speakers. And we're going to move on. I think there's more to Day of the Dead, right? Yes, a celebration of life, but I think there's more. Let's see. Would these two chiquitas mind telling us a little bit more about El Día de los Muertos? Dania, tell us what you know.
Day of the Dead is also a time for family. We gather as a family to place the offering that remember our loved ones and in some homes to pray.
Thank you, mija. Daphne, would you mind giving us a hand?
El Día de los Muertos es una celebración de familia.
Gracias, amiguitas. Thank you for sharing that. So, Día de los Muertos también es el tiempo de familia. It's time for family. But I think there's more, still more to it, right, Latinos Unidos? Tell me more about El Día de los Muertos. And I'm going to be hearing right now from Ruby and Gael. Hopefully we got Gael in here. Ruby, talk to us. What else is Day of the Dead?
Day of the Dead is a celebration of two worlds, two traditions, two cultures coming together. Our Aztec or indigenous culture and our Spanish one. We are a mestizo or mixed culture. We celebrate the richness of both.
Gracias, Ruby. Gael, would you mind helping us out? If you're here, Gael. Okay, he wasn't able to. Yeah, something about the Chromebook. Well, Gael was going to translate and he was going to say, iba a compartir con nosotros, Gael, que el Día de los Muertos es una celebración de nuestras dos culturas, del culturismo, y es muy importante, especialmente si somos programa de doble inmersión, ¿verdad? Entonces, representa lo que estamos tratando de hacer aquí en nuestra escuela. Thank you to our speakers, that's our Latinos Unidos Club. At home, if you can give them a quick little clap at home to show our support. It takes a lot of courage to talk to an entire school, right? So I'm very proud of them, and I thank them for sharing their understanding, their knowledge about Día de los Muertos. Okay, Russell, Día de los Muertos has one essential component, and that's la ofrenda. We sometimes call it un altar, and we can call it that as well, but it is an ofrenda. An ofrenda in Spanish means an offering. Ofrendas are set up in a private or public space, private in your house, right? We saw a lot of, we're gonna share with you a lot of videos that we have of your altares at home, right? Your ofrendas at home. But they're also, they could also be in public spaces, right? If you've ever been to downtown Santa Ana, they're there, right? They have a whole festival and whatnot. So ofrenda means offering. Can you say that with me in your homes? Ofrenda, offering, right? Thank you for following with me. And they're there to remember and honor the dead, the loved ones that are no longer with us. Let's see real quick before we move on. In your homes, I know I disabled the chat. Sorry, boys and girls. Can anyone think of what should go on an ofrenda? ¿Verdad? Desactivé la sala de charlar, pero si alguien puede pensar, ¿qué tiene que estar en una ofrenda? ¿Cuáles son algunas cosas que tenemos que colocar en una ofrenda?
Ruby's hands up.
I know, I'm trying to zoom out a little bit. I can't. Would you mind selecting someone, Miss Chrissy? Miss?
Ruby has her hand up.
Let's do three speakers. Can we unmute her? Ruby, can you tell us one thing that's on an ofrenda?
A picture of a family member. That's the most important.
Oh, that's the most important thing. I'm glad you said that, Ruby. You're going to segue into the next section right now. Miss Haas, can you pick another student, maybe a primary student, if they have their hand up?
Freddie has his hand up. Freddie,
puedes. Puedes activar tu micrófono.
Freddy and Alina.
Day of the Dead.
¿Qué tenemos que tener en una ofrenda? What do we have to have in an ofrenda, mijo?
Bread of the Dead.
Bread of the Dead. Pan del Muerto. Gracias. So we heard photographs, We heard pan de muerto. Man, these scholars are experts.
De flores.
Mayra, Mayra Morales. Mayra. Gracias,
Mayra. Sorry, Mayra. Yeah. Go right ahead, mija. Mayra. Mayra, ¿qué necesitamos en una ofrenda? What do we need in an ofrenda, mija?
We need photos.
We need photos. Okay, we heard photos. We heard flowers.
Candles.
And candles and pan de muerto. And it looks like you folks already know it all, right? Thank you for sharing, scholars. Okay, it's Mr. Chang. Mr. Chang is here, right? Okay, so Ruby brought up a good point. The most essential part are photographs, right? And I'm gonna go ahead and unshare the PowerPoint because we have Mr. Chang and he's gonna talk to us about two very special loved ones in his family. Right? Sorry, Mr. Chang. This is the biggest I can get it. Right? And Mr. Chang, are you here?
Hey, good morning, Ms. Hill.
We unmute you. Go ahead, Mr. Chang.
All right. Good morning, scholars. I also want to thank Ms. Haas for translating for me.
Buenos días. La señora Haas va a hacer la traducción para esta parte.
So, scholars. First of all, I want to say one of the many things that I love about Russell is that we have so many different families and so many different staff members that are from different countries.
La primera cosa que quiero decir es que una cosa que me fascina de la escuela Russell es que tenemos representantes de tantas diferentes lugares, diferentes culturas.
At Russell, we celebrate all these different cultures.
A Russell celebramos todas estas diferentes culturas.
We honor all these different cultures.
Honramos todas las culturas.
We have families, students from Mexico, Vietnam.
Tenemos familias de México, de Vietnam.
We have different principals that have family from China and Germany.
Tenemos también un director que tiene familia de China y de Alemania.
We even have different teachers from Europe and Switzerland.
Y tenemos también maestras de Europa y no sé cómo decir Switzerland en español.
All these differences are what make Russell beautiful and strong.
Todas las diferencias es lo que hace Russell ser tan bello y tan fuerte.
And even though we have a lot of differences, there's also a lot of similarities.
Y aunque tengamos muchas diferencias, también tenemos muchas cosas iguales.
So since I have come to Russell, and so many of our families have shared some of the beautiful traditions like Day of the Dead with me.
Desde que yo he venido a Russell, me han enseñado los de diferentes culturas como el Día de los Muertos.
I have started this tradition in my household as well.
Yo también empecé esta tradición en mi casa.
And Ms. Hill, if you can screen share the picture of my grandparents, please.
Si puedes enseñar la foto de mis abuelos, por favor.
Scholars, these are my father's parents.
Eruditos, estos son los padres de mi papá.
They are my grandparents.
Son mis abuelos.
They were born and raised in China.
Estaban nacidos y criados en China.
And Ms. Hill, can you also share the altar for my house?
I didn't quite download that one, Mr. Chang. I have to go to my text messages.
But that's okay. That's okay.
Community wants to see those.
So scholars, in my house, I also have an altar.
Eruditos, en mi casa, yo también tengo un altar.
And one of the pictures that is on that altar is my grandparents.
Y una de las fotos que están en mi altar son mis abuelos.
But what is very similar in the Asian culture and we have talked about this during the Chinese New Year.
Lo que es muy similar en la cultura asiano es el Año Nuevo de China, también hacemos esto.
During the Chinese New Year, we also honor our family members that have died.
Durante nuestro Año Nuevo, también honramos a nuestras familias que han muerto, fallecido.
We will also put up pictures in our house, and we will also give them offerings.
Y también ponemos fotos en nuestra casa y les ofrecemos ofrendas también.
So even though the Chinese culture may be very different than some of the Latin American cultures.
So, aunque la cultura de China quizás sea un poco diferente de lo Latinoamérica,
we also have very many similarities.
También tenemos muchas cosas similares.
So again, as we celebrate the Day of the Dead at Russell.
So también, como celebramos el Día de las Muertes, de la Muerte, en la Escuela Russell.
It is one of the things that makes Russell such a truly special school.
Es una de las cosas que hace a la Escuela Russell tan especial.
We honor, appreciate, and respect all different cultures.
Honramos, agradecemos, y más que nada respetamos todas las culturas representadas aquí.
And all these differences is what makes us a beautiful school and makes us stronger all together.
Y todas las diferentes culturas es lo que hace Russell ser una escuela bella y más fuerte.
So thank you, Ms. Hill, for always doing this each and every year for all of us.
Gracias, señorita Hill, por hacer este evento tan especial para nosotros cada año.
And now I'd like to turn it back over to Ms. Hill.
Ms. Hill.
Gracias, Mr. Chang. Me encantó que habló mucho Mr. Chang sobre el multiculturalismo. Mr. Chang spoke about our multiculturalism, and that's what makes Russell such a unique and very special community that we have here. He mentioned a photograph. He shared the photograph of his grandparents, but I know, Russell, that we not only put photographs on the ofrenda, we have other items on the ofrenda that are equally as essential, right? And we have a couple of our teachers share with us what the other items are that we put on an ofrenda. Ahora le vamos a dar la palabra a algunas maestras que van a compartir con nosotros cuáles son esas otras cosas que tenemos que tener en una ofrenda. Entonces, ellas van a compartir con nosotros esos artículos que también son esenciales en una ofrenda, ¿verdad? Una ofrenda, como les acabo de decir, it's an offering, right? So let's go ahead and learn a little bit more about what goes on an ofrenda, right? Mr. Chang just shared about photographs. Maestra Gallardino nos puede platicar un poquito del pan de muerto. Ms. Gallardino is going to talk to us about the Day of the Dead bread. Maestra Gallardino.
Perdón. Hola, buenos días, perdón. Buenos días, buenos días. Pan de muerto. El pan de muerto irónicamente representa la vida. El pan sirve como alimento para los muertos que están en nuestros corazones. Sin pan, no hay vida. El pan se coloca en canastas alrededor de la ofrenda.
Gracias, Maestra Gallardino. Ms. Gallardino, our kindergarten dual language teacher, just shared about the Day of the Dead bread. And ironically, it's called Day of the Dead bread, but it's actually all about life, and it represents life, right? And bread is essential to living, right? We don't have bread, we don't have life. And she shared with us that it's usually placed in baskets and kind of decorates the ofrenda. It's all, it's surrounding the ofrenda. But I know that's not the only thing. And I know Mr. Castillo, one of our first grade dual language teachers, is going to talk to us about not just flowers in general, but a flower in particular. Señor Castillo? Miss Chrissy, if you can help me spotlight.
Hola, sí, aquí. Buenos días. Buenos días a todos. Buenos días, Russell. Estudiantes, maestros. Feliz viernes. Sí. So, las flores para...
Oh, he just got muted. But, un momento.
Ahí está. ¿Otra vez? Ahí está.
Otra vez. ¿Por qué no? No,
okay. Lo... Está bien. Flores. En particular, la flor de cempasúchil. ¿Pueden tratar de decir la palabra conmigo? Cempasúchil.
Cempasúchil.
¿Eh? En tu casa. No, no, no te hagas el mute. Gracias. Gracias. Cempasúchil. Es una palabra náhuatl, el lenguaje de los aztecas de México, y significa flor de 20 pétalos. El color naranja de esta flor y su aroma profundo sirven para guiar a los muertos de regreso a la tierra y a nuestros corazones. Las flores, porque vienen de la tierra, también representan la tierra, uno de los cuatro elementos de la vida.
Gracias, señor Castillo. Mr. Castillo, our first grade dual language teacher, just shared the significance of a very specific flower, marigold in English, right? But in Spanish, or actually in Nahuatl, the indigenous language of the Aztecs, it's called cempasúchil. If you've ever smelled it, it has a really strong aroma. Actually, if you go to any store right now, you're going to see it everywhere being sold right now. The flower represents the earth. It comes from the earth, and the earth or the dirt is one of the four elements of life. Thank you, Mr. Castillo, for sharing that with us. We're going to go ahead and move on. That's not the only thing that an ofrenda needs. Ooh, this is the one I'm sure a lot of our kiddos love this part, right? The sugar stools. Maestra Sepúlveda is going to talk to us about that.
Buenos días, estudiantes. Las calaveras de ofrenda. La figura ofrenda puede estar completa sin las calaveras de azúcar. Estas calaveritas representan a los muertos, a nuestros seres queridos que ya no están con nosotros. Tradicionalmente, los nombres de los seres queridos están escritos en el cráneo y estas calaveritas también representan los antiguos sistemas de creencias de los aztecas.
Gracias, Maestra Sepúlveda, nuestra maestra de segundo grado. She's our second grade teacher in our dual language program, and she shared about sugar skulls, and they actually represent the dead, right? But let's face it, we're looking for the sweetness of those sugar skulls, right? These sugar skulls also represent the ancient beliefs of the Aztecs. So they serve a dual purpose. But I don't know, Day of the Dead, we've got sugar, we've got flowers. I know there's more that we need. Maestra Madeline is going to share with us right now another element in our ofrenda. Ms. Madeline?
Good morning, Russell Scholars. I'm going to be talking about water. Why water? Because we get thirsty and so do our loved ones. Water is one of the four elements of life. Water, along with salt, help to purify and cleanse our souls, the souls of our loved ones.
Y el último elemento ahorita que compartió la maestra Madeline es la sal y el agua. Es uno de los elementos de la vida y ya saben que el agua purifica. Y por eso es importante de colocarlo en nuestra ofrenda. We also have other items, I imagine, right? That doesn't complete the ofrenda. Ms. Vong, would you mind talking to us about another element that we must place in the ofrenda?
Of course. Hi, Russell Scholars. So the other element that we put in our ofrenda is papel picado. Papel picado are punch or punch papers flies in the air in different colorful designs. The ancient Aztecs in Mexico made a textile from the bark of trees, which they would paint and use to decorate their religious sculptures and sites. Papel picado represents air, one of the four elements of life. Thank you.
Gracias, Maestra Wong. Maestra de cuarto grado compartió con nosotros el significado del papel picado. Papel picado representa el aire, uno de los elementos de la vida, y también tiene raíces indígenas. We're going to go ahead and move on because there's more, right? There's more to our friend. Mr. Hall, would you mind telling us another item that needs to be placed on an ofrenda?
Good morning, everyone. Buenos días. Buenos días, escolares, and parents and teachers. And what I want to share about is candles. Candles. Candles light the way for our loved ones to join us in our hearts. Their light represents life, faith, and hope. For some, each candle also represents each soul or loved one. So in other words, you light a candle for each loved one. Candles also represent fire, one of the four elements of life. Thank you.
Gracias, señor Hall. Él es nuestro maestro de quinto grado. Compartió el significado de las velas o de la lumbre, ¿verdad? Y es uno de los elementos también de la vida, que ya viene siendo el fuego, la lumbre, y estas velas representan vida, esperanza, y también la fe, ¿verdad? Gracias, señor Hall. Y por último, no va a ser ofrenda. We can't have an ofrenda without comida, right? Food. Tenemos a la maestra Kobayashi. Ms. Kobayashi, would you mind talking to us about that?
Good morning, Russell Scholars. I would like to share about food, because what is a celebration without food? Families often place mole, tamales, and other traditional foods, as well as the favorite dishes and objects of the departed. For example, if your grandma enjoyed playing cards, we place a deck of cards on the ofrenda so she can enjoy it.
Gracias, Maestra Kobayashi. Es nuestra maestra de sexto grado y compartió lo que algunos chiquitos quizás piensan que es lo más esencial, que es la comida, ¿verdad? Y los artículos personales de nuestros seres queridos. Le agradecemos. Thank you to our teachers for sharing that. You didn't expect this, right, boys and girls? But we wouldn't have an assembly without a short lesson about Día de los Muertos, right? Check. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and move on. We thank our teachers for sharing that with us. And this year, we decided to do a digital ofrenda. And that means that you shared photographs with us, videos on Flipgrid. And what we're going to share with you right now is a digital ofrenda or a video collage of those items that you shared with us. I will tell you, however, that we got a lot of videos, right? They're not all going to be included in this video collage, but I will tell you that it's actually going to be posted on our YouTube page, so you can see it there too. And all the other Flipgrid videos, they're going to be there as well, for you to see them individually, okay? So I want to preface this by saying that, okay? Ahora vamos a irnos a la próxima parte, que es nuestra ofrenda digital. Ustedes compartieron fotografías, videos a través de la aplicación de Flipgrid. Y esto es la combinación de todas esas cosas que compartieron con nosotros, pero sí les quiero decir que no pudimos compartir cada video, pero sí va a estar disponible en línea si lo quiere ver más tarde, ¿ok? Oh, wait, hold on just a second. Let me make sure I share my audio. Let me just make sure I have my audio on.
We could hear it when you started it.
Okay, thank you, sorry, just want to make sure. Okay, thank you. Okay, perdón, es que no puedo ver. Okay, denme un segundito, no puedo ver. Okay, sorry. Ah.
es abuela Mirta. Esto es abuelo Cecil. Eso es abuela Betty. Y él es tío Charlie.
Día de los Muertos to me is a celebration on November where we always have to remember our family members who have passed away. And I have one. This is my tía Romelia, my grandpa's oldest sister. She was my favorite. She was kind. She was generous. She was brave. She was confident. She was generous. She was love sharing. She was appreciated, and I will always remember her with all of my heart.
Hello, my name is Nathan, and I wanted to present my great aunt, Cha-Cha, and one memory I had of her is that she always used to give me money and she always used to buy ice cream for me. And that she was so nice and we always used to talk all the time. And she almost died a year ago on October 28th, 2019. And the picture with me wearing my blue and black shirt, that was the last picture I took with her before she went inside the hospital. And we miss Cha-Cha a lot and we loved her a lot. Yep.
Hi, Russell families and students. I just wanted to join in on the celebration of the Day of the Dead. And I just wanted to let you know that even though it's not part of my culture to celebrate this holiday, I just wanted to know you to know that I respect and love this holiday very much because you are, I think it stands out to me that you are recognizing and celebrating people's lives and not through mourning them, but looking at their accomplishments. And so I just wanted to bring out that this year we lost our sweet Rosemary. She's an aunt to me, but more like a mother. And she was always there for us and taking care of us and supporting us, but she was also giving back to the community. She was a teacher for 30 years and she was always cheering people on and serving her community around her. And so I just wanted to celebrate her life today with you.
Día de los Muertos is for me that it's like a culture and I get to celebrate my uncle. He was a very nice uncle, but he probably never knew that I was his niece because he really didn't see me that much, but I felt that he was my uncle. So I always loved him because he was the one who showed me kindness and always played with me.
Hola, este es mi alter. Tiene muchas cosas que hacen los ancestros. Mis ancestros se hacen muchas cosas porque es poner las cosas que puede hacer cuando está viviendo.
Thank you.
Day of the Dead, we're going to put an ofrenda and we're going to put fruit, drinks, candles, and flowers. This is my abuelo Francisco, and he's from my mom's side. He passed away 2 weeks ago at age 90. In Dia de los Muertos, we're going to celebrate him with an ofrenda with a lot of fruits, drinks, and candles. And on the other ofrenda, I'm going to add my other grandpa and my great-grandma. Even though I didn't meet him, I knew he was a hardworking man and loved his family so much.
This is my great uncle. He would jump on the floor and play cards with me. He was one of my best friends, even though he's not a stranger or anything, but he's a family member. But I think he's like my best friend. I miss him. I love him. Everyone in my family misses him and loves him. This year we are going to celebrate for him, and we all miss him very much, especially my Nana. It was a sad moment when he went away, but we all keep him in our heart. We will never forget him. We will always love him. So that is why we are going to celebrate him. He was a very good great uncle. He never was mean to me. He always had fun with me. And even when he was busy, he would still have fun with me. He was my favorite great uncle.
Abuelos, mi amiga de mi mamá, mi bisabuela, mi bisabuelo y mi tía. Son importantes porque me hacen feliz. Adiós.
Cuando al pasar yo te vi, salías del templo un día, llorona, cuando al pasar yo te vi. Hermoso Bill Llevaba.
I want to be talking about my tío Mario, who passed. So he was 37 when he passed away, and he had a disease called lupus. And I was 2 months old when he passed away. So the only memories that we have of him are when my family talk about him. And the things he loved was music and his DJ set.
Mi hermana ya se falleció. Y estaba dentro de mi mamá panza, pero estaba chiquito.
Todos me dicen el negro llorona, negro pero cariñoso. Todos me dicen el negro llorona.
Día de los Muertos for me is about to remember about the people we care about and to remember about their past. Día de los Muertos for me is to remember about my family and to about their past and how they lived and what they did. And for me, it was my two uncles were the best people. They were really nice and they really cared about me. They always thought I would do really great and they always believed in me.
Until you're in my arms again. And the people I want to remember for Day of the Dead is my grandparents from my mom's side, my maternal grandparents. This is my grandma and my grandpa. I knew them ever since I was a little baby. Like, I grew up with them, and I'm so grateful that I had the opportunity to get to know them
all the way to my high school years. So it was, I grew up with them. They taught me a lot. They taught me Chinese. They taught me how to always work hard and that school was really important.
So Day of the Dead is a day that we respect the our loved ones that passed away. And this is my great-grandfather. He was very old. I only got to meet him like 4 times. One when I was a baby and the other 3 times when I visited him when I was coming back from Mexico.
Keep our love alive, I'll never fade away. If you close your eyes and let the music play, keep our love alive, I'll never fade away. If you close your eyes and let the music play, keep our love alive, I'll never fade away. Remember me, for I was only gone. Remember me, and let the love we have live on. And know that I'm with you, the only way that I can be. So until you're in my arms again, remember me. Remember me. Remember me.
I felt like crying.
Thank you so much, scholars, for joining us this morning in celebration of Dia de los Muertos, Day of the Dead. I just want to remind you that that video is available on our YouTube page. I also want to remind you that there were many of you that submitted videos, I know, and they are available for our entire community to see on Flipgrid. So if you go back to that site that I first, now you see everybody's videos now. They're now public, but they're only going to be public for 1 week, okay? I do want to respect your time and putting that together. Lo voy a decir en español rápidamente. Les quiero decir que ese video que acaban de ver está disponible en nuestra página YouTube. Lo pueden ver allí, en la página de Russell, y también todos los videos de Flipgrid, porque habían más, están disponibles, ahora ya son públicos, los pueden ver al sitio de Flipgrid y ver cada uno de esos videos. We want to thank you for letting us inside your homes, those of you that shared your altares that you have at home. Les queremos agradecer las puertas de sus casas y compartieron esas altares que tienen, esas prendas que tienen. Thank you for joining us this morning. And Mr. Chang, any final announcement before we close our Dia de los Muertos celebration? Any final words from our leadership?
Weren't we asking some of the kinder families?
I was about to say that, but anything else you wanna say before we close that this part?
No.
Okay, pues muchas gracias familias por acompañarnos. Thank you Russell families for joining us. Feliz Día de los Muertos. Happy Day of the Dead. And one final thing, if you are in kindergarten, please stay behind. Un último anuncio, si usted tiene un niño en kinder, o kinder transicional, perdón, por favor, permanezcan en el Zoom. Scholars, for the rest of you, we are going to dismiss you now. You will be logging into your class.